morning, my dear students. We are back with our physics lecture. In the last video, we have discussed about the electromagnet. What is the electromagnet? Electromagnet is nothing but which works on the principle of electricity and a magnet. When we pass an electric current, to the particular circuit, it behaves like a magnet. So that is nothing but it is called as a electromagnet. In the last video, we have learned what is the principle of the electromagnet. Now, can you just tell me where we can use this concept of the electromagnet? Where we can use in our day-to-day life? Can we use this concept of electromagnet in our day-to-day life? Yes, there are many different applications where we use the concept of electromagnet. For example, to carry the heavy load, we use the electromagnet. Or when a magnetic material, if you want to bifurcate it, then we use the concept of electromagnet. Are you getting? In ATM, you might have seen ATM. Have you seen the ATM? Yes, you have seen the ATM. Now, in that you can see this is a ATM, right? Can you see this? Yes. Now you can see the black strip behind this. Yes, this works on the principle of electromagnet. When you insert a ATM in an ATM machine, at that time it gives all the information on your ATM machine. Am I right? How is it possible? Because of the strip, the black strip, in that all the information is hidden. Am I right? This works on the principle of electromagnet. Then dentist use. Sometimes doctors uses this electromagnet also. Now how they can use? See, if a small tiny particle of the iron is inserted in our eye, suppose any small iron particle has gone in our eye. At that time, to remove that iron particle, the doctor uses a electromagnet concept. Am I right? The doctor uses the electromagnet concept to remove the iron particle. In the class 6, in a magnetic lesson, we have learned the MRI machine, which works on the principle of electromagnet. Are you ready? So these are some applications where we use the electromagnet concept. In our home, we use the concept of electromagnet. Now everyone is having the electric bell. Yes or no? Or we can say the doorbell. Yes, everyone is having at their home. It works on the principle of electromagnet. How it works on the principle of electromagnet? That we will see. So see, this is a diagram. In your book, it is given very short diagram. In your NCERT book, this diagram is given. Am I right? So instead of this, you just go through this diagram. I have drawn in a detail this diagram. So see, this is a construction. When this question will come for you for the 5 marks, do explain the concept of electric bell. So what things you have to write? See, when the 5 marks question is asked, then you have to explain the particular answer in a detail. Okay? So what is electric bell? Electric bell, or you can say doorbell. Everyone is having at their home. Yes or no? So electric bell works on the principle of electromagnet. So this is the first point you can write. Electric bell works on the principle of electromagnet. Then you have to draw this diagram. So what things are there? Then after drawing the diagram, first you will explain the concept of electric bell. It works on the principle of electromagnet. Then you will draw this diagram. Now what is there in electric bell? Now what is the exactly there? See, in that this is a magnet. This is a magnet. U-shaped. This magnet is called as a U-shaped magnet. This is a U-shaped magnet. In that magnet, we have rounded a coil. We have wounded a coil to this magnet. Are you getting this? What we have done? This is a magnet. We have wounded a coil to this magnet. Then this magnet is in front of this magnet. This is an iron bar. This is an iron bar which is also called as armature. It is also called as armature. The first is what we will write. It consists of U-shaped magnet. Then in front of this, this is a armature. This is a armature which is made up of iron bar. Are you getting this? This iron bar or armature at the end, one front end, or you can say the above this armature, one hammer is attached to it. Above this armature, at the end of the pole, what it is attached? Hammer. Hammer is attached. And a sound pole. At the next end of the pole, what it is attached? Flat spring. This is a flat spring which is attached. This flat spring, to give the support, we have taken a metal bucket. Are you getting? To this flat spring, the support is given by the metal bucket. Are you getting? Then the hammer, after hammer, there is a metallic gong. This is a metallic gong. Now what is the use of this metallic gong? That we will see. Okay, afterwards. First this is a hammer. In front of the hammer, there is a metallic gong. Are you getting this? And this armature consists of in front of armature, the armature is attached to the contact screw. The armature, this iron bar, is attached to the contact screw. This is a contact screw. Are you getting? And the electromagnet, this magnet is wounded by the wire which is attached. The another end of the wire is attached to the battery and the push button. Are you getting? It is attached to the battery and the push button. So what is exactly the construction of the electric bell? Have you understood? See, once again, it consists of U-shaped magnet. In that, what is around is the metallic wire is wounded around it, and in front of electromagnet or a magnet, what is this? This is an armature. Are you getting? And at the end of this pole, near the end of the pole of the armature, hammer is attached and a flat spring is attached. Above, the hammer is attached and flat spring is attached. In front of the hammer, there is a metallic gong. And this armature is also attached to the contact screw. Are you getting this? So this is the construction of a electric bell. So what things first you have to write? First you will write the concept of electric bell. It works on the principle of electromagnet. Then you have to draw the diagram. Then after the diagram, you will write the construction of electric
bed. And after construction, we will write working. Now, how it works? How this electric bell works? Okay. Now, what is this? This is a push button. Now, you know there is a this push button is also called as a switch. Okay. Now, when you are pressing the bell, that button is called as a push button. Okay. Now, see how what is the actually working of the electric bell. As soon as this button is pressed, this is a battery. The electric current starts to flow. Are you getting? And this magnet become magnetized. This coil become a magnetized, and it starts to behave like a magnet. And as it starts to behave like a magnet, the iron bar come close to this magnet. Are you getting? This U-shaped magnet attached as it is an iron. It get attract towards the magnet. As it get attracted, this hammer comes in a contact with metal bar. And now I have told you that what is the use of metal bar? Metal bar, as it hammers to this bar, it starts ringing. Here is the sound is produced. Are you getting? This hammer this metal bar. Are you getting? The hammer hammers this metal bar and sound is produced. And the contact between the contact screw and the iron bar, it gets break. Are you getting? It gets break. As it gets breaks, after some time when a current starts flowing, this is a spring. Am I right? The spring breaks in the bar. The iron bar, the spring tries to pull the iron bar, and the contact between this contact screw get attached. Are you getting? The contact between the contact screw and the iron bar again get attached. Are you getting? And the circuit is completed. Again it loses this, the electromagnet, this loses the magnet, loses its magnetism. So again this armature goes to its original place. Are you getting? So this is the working of electric bell. This is the working of electric bell. So once again, see the working, exactly the working of electric bell. This is the electromagnet. As we start or when we switch on the button, we push the button, the electricity starts to flow this coil, and it behaves like a magnet. As it behaves like a magnet, this is an armature which pulls the iron, which is made up of iron. It pulls the iron, and contact between this contact screw is get broken, and hammer at this end hammer this metal gong, and it produces the sound. The metal gong produces the sound. So we can hear the sound of bell. Are you getting? And this is a flat spring. The flat spring brings the armature to its original position. As it brings to the original position, the circuit is completed. It breaks the contact, and again the contact between the contact screw get attached to this iron bar. This contact screw get attached to this iron bar. Are you getting this? So this is the working of electric bell. So draw this diagram. in your physics notebook.
Pause the video and draw this diagram in your physics notebook.
Are you getting? It is not there in your NCERT book. So draw this diagram properly in your physics notebook. The question may ask for 5 marks. In that you have to write the principle, diagram, construction and the working, which will give you full mark. Are you getting? So I hope you have understood the electric bell. So draw this diagram. So today's work will be, you have to draw this diagram. Try to write this all the point in your physics notebook. I hope you have understood it. Thank you.